Welcome back to Retro Cave. Thanks for tuning in again. I have really looked forward to making this video, as this will be the first real highlight for my still very young channel here. What you see here is a brand new, still sealed, AOC 17-inch CRT monitor. I had this in storage for quite some time, and today we are going to unbox this beauty. And well, in case it works, we are also doing some tests with it. For these tests, we will use this little 486 DX33 here that we just replaced the hard disk in one of my previous videos. You can watch this if you haven't already. It had a broken hard disk and we replaced it with a new one. Okay, but now it's time to start here, and Dani is helping again. She was also looking forward to this, especially since the monitor is supposed to go to her retro gaming place, together with the small computer here. Okay. Open this up, and we found the bill for the monitor inside, and as you can see, €379 was its price, and it was bought on the 29th of October in 2001 in a local store here in Germany. Amazing, right? Someone must have shoven the bill from the side under the lid and thought that this would be a good place to store it. Yeah, as you can see, the all is still sealed, the manual and all accessories, power cable, brand new, €20. I mean, it's nearly 20 years now, right? Oh, we discovered the bugs here, yes!
Bum, 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 bum.
And no wonder that the Windows Millennium computer always crashed back in the time when your bugs were delivered free house with your monitors. So now we finally have this reason. They must have crawled in from the side sometime in the last 20 years. We've turned the monitor around now, and I helped with that. And now the box is off, and here it is. Look how white this thing is. And more bugs. A lot of more bugs. They must have breed it in there. And at some parties. Total bug graveyard here. Just good that they are dead so they can't infest the computer anymore, right? Okay, let's turn it around so we can see the front. Also looks nice. And you can see the control wheel. It must be for the one wheel for the entire menu control. Curious to see how this will work. Okay, now let's get it out of the plastic. Little help. So cool. Okay, next we'll try and get the foot on it. And this took a while.
Oh.
But we got it in the end. Okay, now it's time to turn it around. So, quick cut here. And let's remove the last plastic covers here. And the foil. And look. So amazing that this thing has been in storage for so long. Now being turned on the first time soon. First we need to connect it. So let's connect it to the computer beside it. Also brand new cable here. What? Oh yes, the cable is, you cannot change it. Yeah, those were like budget class monitors, or 17 inch in general. Not all of them had different ports and allowed you to change the VGA cable. Or even connect an BNC cables, that my big ones, almost all of them have BNC cables. That's those five cables, one for each color and vertical and horizontal sync. But in this class of monitors, it was not common for these connections. All right, now just the power. Connected. Then we can turn. It's already on. It didn't have a power switch. So immediately power was in and great. We were really relieved that it also showed its test picture. Now turn on the computer and see if we get a signal. It's already green and here it comes. First run for this monitor. Amazing. As you can see, it's a bit bright, but we have to adjust this in the menu. And I'm pretty sure it has 100 contrast. That's a standard setting for those monitors. And we restart it one more time. Now let's go to DOS shell, so we can see white. I don't have any other test programs here on this little 486, so we just have to use the DOS programs here. But clear white. Total bright, no color, and no color problems in the white. So this is the menu. As you can see, 100 contrast is really bad. Turn this down. For those brand new monitors, 50 should be enough, or they will wear out fast. And as you can see, we have 70 hertz. That's standard under DOS, but I like it higher. And I will show you later how you can increase your hertz frequency under DOS. That's also some knowledge that got lost in the 20 years. Well, you can see color settings here, more reductions, size changes of the picture. It's all analog. And we have this one here.
Oh.
Degauss. Degaussing a CRT. Also nice. Brand new CRT. Okay, what we are gonna do now is we'll do something against this overbright screen here and try to adjust this low enough so we have a beautiful black picture that a CRT can give you while still having a nice contrast. So we are here now in total darkness. Let's check the DOS shell, and as you can see, you don't really notice that we turned down the brightness at all here. But as you can see, when we have a dark screen, the CRT is also now beautifully dark. All right, thank you much for joining us here. And if you are interested in seeing more about this beautiful CRT, then be sure to watch the next video, as we will install the drivers of the sound card, video card and everything on the computer. And we will also launch a game on this monitor. Okay, see you then. Bye bye.